First of all guys, this video is the English version of my previous video which is being recorded or voiceovered in Hindi. So many of my subscribers couldn't understand the Hindi pretty well because it's all about diversity. Every people do not understand Hindi. So this is then the universal language of the English. So let's start. The most difficult thing about nowadays is to increase the efficiency of the engine in the automobile world. So two more stroke is being introduced in the conventional four stroke engine to make it more efficient. Well, let me correct you, it is not in the practical world, it is only in the conceptual and the prototyping world. So let's understand what is the concept behind a six stroke engine. Hello guys, my name is Jay, you are watching Mech Hacks. Let's begin and understand this concept in a few details. Guys, as I earlier mentioned that there is a need, a necessity to increase the thermal efficiency of the IC engine nowadays because we are facing a hell lot of scarcity of the fossil fuel reserves and the petroleum reserves. So two more additional stroke is being introduced in the conventional four-stroke engine. So let us understand what is a four-stroke engine. I presume that you all know. Let me give you a small gist of it. Four stroke engine, as the name says, comprises of the four strokes. The first stroke is the suction stroke. During this, the air fuel mixture is being compressed and sucked into the cylinder for the further strokes, which is followed by the second stroke, that is the compression stroke. During this compression stroke, the inlet valve closes and the piston moves from BDC to TDC followed by the third stroke, which is the power stroke, in which the spark plug induces a spark into it, the air fuel mixture, and the air fuel mixture combusted and bring out a huge lot of amount of energy, which gives the power stroke, followed by the fourth stroke where the exhaust gas come out of the cylinder. After that, two stroke is being introduced in it. It is still in prototyping. The fifth stroke, that is the second power stroke, water is used as expanding secondary fuel for the engine, which is introduced with the help of secondary water inlet system. Followed by the sixth stroke, which is the second exhaust stroke, the water is being taken in the fifth stroke, is being exhausted out with the help of exhaust valve, the water exhaust valve, to the atmosphere in the vapor phase. Now guys, let us understand what exactly happens during these two strokes. Well, as you know that at the end of the fourth stroke, where the combustion gases is about to get exhausted from the valve and it create a huge amount of heat energy, then this heat energy is used to vaporize the water that has been introduced from the water inlet valve in the beginning of the fifth stroke, and that water vaporizes, expand in a very great way, and pushes the piston from top dead center to bottom dead center, giving an additional power stroke with the same amount of fuel consumption, and which theoretically increases 40% of the fuel consumption. So in a six stroke engine, energy absorption is less because of the slower acceleration of the reciprocating parts. So the energy loss is also less in it. Guys, I hope you understood the working phenomena of the six stroke engine. It is still in prototyping, not in the real world. And if you have any queries about it, please write it down in the comments. Let us now go through the advantages quickly. The first thing is the thermal efficiency increases by 50%. Yes, exactly, it increases by the 50%. Not exactly 50%. We can assume that it will increase by 30%. Yeah, exactly. Now, the next thing is that fuel consumption reduces, is the vice versa effect. If it increases the thermal efficiency, obviously the fuel consumption decreases. Now, there is a reduction in the chemical noise and the thermal pollution. Exactly, it's a reduction in the thermal pollution because the exhaust gas is not now coming out of the exhaust. It is now the clean, or you can say that overall clean exhaust of the water vapor is coming out of the exhaust. Now, two expansion work stroke we are getting in a single working cycle, and we can eliminate the radiator too. We have to introduce some of the cooling system, but we can eliminate the radiator to cool down the engine. Not completely, but we can make the radiator small. Of you will tell that there is this problem, there is this problem, there is the coefficient of expansion problem with the water and many more things. Yeah, this is true. There are still modifications that is being done by the research and development. But take out 1 minute and think that what can this machine give to our society, our civilization? It can make a huge hell lot of difference. So guys, I hope that you like this video, you get to know some stuff about it. So any query or suggestion, please comment down below, and do like the video, subscribe and share if you want. This is Mech Hacks, over and out.